13 degrees outside. Man, it's cold. I don't want to get out from here. No way. Yeah, even though I slept pretty well, but I woke up because it's cold. Sorry for my voice and for my face and yeah, for everything. Let's get up. 我有热水。 It's better.
Hainan winters are always like this. Sometimes it can drop down to around 10 degrees. Yes, it doesn't sound like cold weather, but the combination of the humidity and the wind can make you feel differently, especially when you stay in your tent right at the seashore. However, hot fresh coffee and bright sunshine warmed me up after a cold night and I was ready to explore the western part of Hainan Island. My first destination was the city of Danzhou. The first thing I noticed riding on the western part of Hainan was there were a lot of dusty dirt roads.
Okay, the end of the good road.
Of course, there is a comfortable highway, but motorcycles are not allowed to enter. And even if they were allowed, I would actually prefer the dirt roads because, come on, they're much more fun. When I stopped for breakfast in the town of Wanwu, I found out that local people in Danzhou like to eat a special type of rice noodles called Milan noodles.
This is your Danzhou's signature, right? I'll have a Milan one.
Don't worry, it doesn't have any connection with Italy. The name comes from the local Danzhou dialect. The dish is quite similar to Hainan noodles, but Milan noodles are thinner and they've got more ingredients inside. And when you eat them on a hot day, they taste very refreshing.
Just 7 RMB. So cheap.
On the way to Danzhou, I saw a lot of different plantations that I've never seen before.
It looks beautiful. It's like some kind of cactus. Oh, there are a lot of people working there. 你们好。谢业长。谢业长。谢业长。宣言长。宣言长。好，可以辛苦你们。好。Oh,
my poor Chinese. None of the pronunciation options were correct. This is 仙人掌, a type of cactus. Interesting fact, if it translated literally to English, it would be the palm of the immortal.
This is dragon fruit. This is a bad one. This is the first time I see, actually.
Farmers usually install lights to help produce better fruits because it requires a lot of light. It's incredible to see how much work has been put into building a plantation like this.
You see, you have to set up all the lights. They're everywhere. I guess this is very beautiful at night. It's very expensive and troublesome to keep and take care of dragon fruit plantations. This day is good.
I didn't have so many plans for the city of Danzhou, I just needed to find an internet bar and copy all my footage. The place I really wanted to go that day was the biggest artificial lake in Hainan, Songtao Shuiku.
Just look at this, guys. This is where I'm going.
After I checked the photos online, I got extremely excited about it. I wanted to see that magnificent scenery, put my tent on the lakeside and enjoy the grace of Mother Nature. The road to the lake was really bumpy, dusty and unpleasant to ride on, but when I arrived there, it didn't really matter because the view was fantastic and all of my expectations were absolutely right.
What the Maya! This is what I need. Oh man! Yes, look at this beauty.
However, I spent quite some time looking for a better camping spot, but eventually I found a really good one with no people around and a beautiful view.
这边的水你们看，非常非常干净，真的。
我的妈呀，我觉得这里可以游泳。
There are some people who came there to swim, and they told me, "Come on, let's go." And I thought, "Why not? Let's go."
有得上吗？
可以
直接喝吗？哇
！That was incredible. Such a clean and pure water. I won't say anything. It was just great. Well, thank you.
As I mentioned before, Songtao Shuikou is the biggest man-made lake in Hainan and one of the biggest in China. The crystal clear water is like a natural mirror reflecting the surrounding nature. There is a fantastic mountain landscape on the horizon and small islands scattered on the lake's surface. All of this contributes to making the place spectacular. What's more, it is of great importance for Hainan's water supply, irrigation, cultivation, fishery, electricity, and much more.
Everything is set for the night. The tent.Right here, need to move all the things. The sun is already down. It was a beautiful sunset. Yeah, it's not bad. It's not bad. Oh, someone is texting me. Cool.
Yeah, at least I will not feel so lonely.
真冷，真冷啊！大岩，快来，快来，快来！我要做一个热身，呼好一点。Good morning, everybody. Oh, this is another beautiful morning out here. It's always like this, you know, you have a really bad night at tent and you sleep not so well and then you wake up like before the sunrise and you feel very, very bad. I mean, you feel like it's cold, it's windy, it's dark and you're like, oh, what the hell? Why did I choose camping? Why did I choose sleeping in a tent? But then the sun is coming up and then you realize everything. Why you came here for. Yeah, this is it. And this is all yours. This is all yours. Probably there is somebody heard me. Whew, time to go.
I would say Songtao Shuikou is one of the places I liked the most throughout the trip. Its remoteness and untouched nature gave me a real deep impression and somehow reminded me of my home.
Bye bye, Songtao Shuikou. I'll miss you.
The closest town to the lake was the town of Nanfeng, where I stopped for breakfast and tried their local food, sweet potato rice noodles.
你们好，你们这里有早餐吗？
早餐有。
啊。
地瓜粉还有面。
我可以干一下吗？地瓜粉。
嗯。就是这个，可以说的。
这是你们的特色吗？
哎，对对对，我们海南特色。啊，你要一份是这种？
对，我要品尝一下。
哎，好，坐下。
好，谢谢。
我的地瓜粉来了。
The duguafen was really good for breakfast. Fresh, a bit sweet and sour, all you need for a hot day. It's incredible to think how many varieties of rice noodles Hainan can offer. Almost each town has their own local rice noodles.
点赞。
Shop owners were so friendly and hospitable that they didn't let me pay. I tried to insist on paying, but eventually they didn't let me do it.
好，谢谢你们。
不客气。
Once again, this moment proves how kind and welcoming the local people are.
好的，走了。要跟你啊，工作来，你再进来吃早餐。好，没问题。好，谢谢，拜拜。
My next stop was one of my favorite places on the island, Baisha County.
Baisha, let's go! These are old rubber trees.
The first reason why I like this place so much is the location. It is located in mountains in the center of the island, and any road you take leads you through the mountain roads with picturesque views.
Look at this!
Another reason is Baisha tea. The town is surrounded by vast tea plantations, and Baisha tea is considered one of the best teas in Hainan.
These are all tea plantations.
Hey guys, what's up? High five.
Since ancient times, tea has been an essential part of Chinese culture. The most famous teas come from the mainland of China, from provinces like Fujian, Jiangsu, Yunnan, and others. But not so many people know that Hainan has got its own tea. Let me explain you what makes Baisha tea so unique. The thing is, the tea is grown on the slopes of a meteorite crater. Yes, you didn't mishear it. 700,000 years ago, an asteroid fell down and exploded right here in Baisha County. Now you can barely see the results of it, but the soil still contains plenty unique minerals. And together with the absence of pollution in the area, abundant rainfall and fog throughout the year, all of these factors make the tea rare and unique. And trust me, the tea is really good. I drink it every day at home, and I also send it to my family, and they love it.
What? This is a coffee tree. This is a coffee tree.
Well, I certainly did not expect to find coffee trees and tea plantations. 咖啡花. 非常香.
Just imagine, close to the tea plantation, there is a coffee trees plantation. How great is that? It's something that you don't see so often. I have never seen it before. 所以在这个很独特的、很特色的一个地方，我一定要喝一杯咖啡. Let's do it. Drip coffee. 有的时候你们有很多时间，但是你需要一杯咖啡. So this is where the drip coffee comes into play.
To have coffee in the coffee tree plantation. Done. Day number 7 of Hainan round trip. You are amazing, and you guys are amazing too, because you watch this. And you will be more amazing if you put like under this video, you subscribe and share it with your friends. I'll be happier than I am now.
I really wanted to see something that would resemble an actual meteorite crater, because come on, it's a meteorite crater. There's, however, a place on the map and signs along the road that lead you to the location with the exact name. Unfortunately, when I arrived there, it was literally nothing worth seeing.
其实看不出来，这是一个陨石坑。 我听说在这里有的时候你的手机会没有信号，你的设备也会出了什么奇怪的问题，有可能会见到外星人。
没有什么呀，可以上去，但是上面也没有什么东西。没有上去没？没有，我上去了。上面都是森林啊，然后就有一条路，都没有看不到什么。长江有一个七彩镇，有一个梯田，但是没有这么好，但是就是有一个水库，有那个木棉花，现在正好开。然后你在这边一看，特别美。我们也是从青海来的，我们去五指山了。啊，去五指山，对，好，五指山很好玩的地方。该吃的，注意安全。拜拜。
Many people come to this place and get disappointed because the area is still not developed for tourists. However, it's a great place for nature lovers. Since I was in Baisha, of course I had to buy some decent tea before leaving.
春芽，春芽就是春天，春天采摘的，
是吧？对对，我这个我没喝过，这个好喝是吗？
这个也好喝，它有香气，它有那个茶香味比较浓一点。
这个一包多少钱？
25。25行，
那我买这些吧。
你们是哪里人呢？
俄罗斯。
俄罗斯啊？
对，
俄罗斯啊，好朋友。
在你们俄罗斯跟他是对面。是吗？哦，你是黑龙江的吗？
黑龙江。
I was heading to the town of Changjiang to find a place to stay overnight. I was lucky enough to witness a fantastic sunset while riding.
Hello?
Hello?
你从湖南过来的吗？对，我是从湖南过来的。哇，不知我好远了。你是一个人吗？啊，我是一个人。嗯，我是从海口，文昌，万宁，平凉，万都三亚。啊，那就知道五指山。你已经跑了很多吧？一路顺风。啊，一路顺风。好的，拜拜。
I wanted to take a good rest after two nights sleeping in the tent. Unfortunately, the hotel I booked didn't want to check me in, even though online it said they accepted foreigners. It was late, I was exhausted to deal with it, so I thought I deserve something good for that night. So I booked a little bit more expensive hotel and did not regret it at all.
Okay. Woo. All right. Oh man, I look so bad. Better not to look in the mirror. I guess I deserve this. Life's hard. Another day, another start.
Another morning, another cup of delicious coffee, and ready to set out for a new adventure. I was heading to the city of Dongfang, the biggest city on the west coast of Hainan. Remember the lady who told me that now is the best time for seeing cotton tree flowers? On the way, I saw a sign pointing to the village with those trees. Without hesitation, I made a turn. Cotton tree or kapok tree are both referred to as bombax ceiba. It is widely planted in Southeast Asia. During winter time, the tree blooms with red flowers before the new foliage. Many flowers fall down, but some of them turn into capsules, which, when ripe, contain fibers like cotton, which is later picked and processed. In Chinese, a cotton flower is also called a hero flower because of its red color and the fact that even when it falls down, it does not lose its color. Like a real hero. Later, I found out that cotton trees actually grow all along the road. It gives a spectacular view.
I guess this is corn. The first time I see a cornfield.
The first thing I noticed in Dongfang was that there was a special lane for motorcycles at the big intersections. It is so convenient and less dangerous. There is no need to split the lanes in order to get to the motorcycle waiting area. One of the reasons I came to Dongfang was that it has Hainan's most western point. The place is called Yulinzhou, which is translated as Fishscale Delta.
Now I'm officially in Hainan's that way. It's already Vietnam.
In ancient times, Yulinzhou was the top attraction of the island. When people heard about Hainan, they immediately thought about this place. And no wonder why. A night-catching lighthouse, a golden beach with not a fine sand but small white stones, the eternity of the vast sea and the idea that somewhere over there, across the sea, is Vietnam. All of this will definitely make you remember this place.
A little bit different here, I guess. The color is a bit different. It's more like greenish color. Waves, I think, are also different. I don't know, it just feels different. Or maybe I have that thought in my mind that, okay, it's Dongfang. I always wanted to come here and I wanted to see something different. I don't know, but for me, it seems different. Happy Russian Village. These are all mangoes. Woo! Manga paradise.
Обалдеть, минус 38 сегодня. Офигеть.
Later, I headed to the place I was especially excited about. Everybody knows Guilin in the province of Guangxi, the town pictured on the 20 yuan banknote. But not so many people know that Hainan has got its own Guilin, and it's called, well, Little Guilin.
Welcome to Guilin! Even though it's Hainan Xiao Guilin. This is amazing.
The second largest man-made lake in Hainan. Sharp mountains popping out from the ground like stone pillars and colorful rice terraces. All of this creates a gorgeous scenery and gives you a feeling that you had really come to Guilin. I couldn't wait for tomorrow morning to come because I knew that I could get the best shots of the place. And I was right. The morning mist covered the lake as if a blanket of snow. But still, you could see the reflections of the surrounding mountains in the pristine water. The outline of the mountains that begins to appear on the horizon reminds you of greatness and the power of nature. The sun was slowly crawling up behind the mountains, fading away the shadows and chasing away the fog. The new day had come, which will soon disappear as millions of others have amid the green hills and crystal water. Mountains will not remember me, but I will remember them.
I thought, why not to pull over and just enjoy this view. 这条路, 这个优美的风景, 啊, 继续吧, 继续。
The day I was going to visit a local Baisha village, famous for its distinctive houses. It's worth noting that the road I was taking was extremely pleasant to ride. Great scenery, no traffic in fine road conditions, and mangoes everywhere.
Mangoes, mangoes. Look, they're everywhere, on this side of the road and that side of the road. Mangoes. What the hell?
Baisha village is a traditional village of the Hainan native Li ethnic minority. The village has 81 so-called boat-shaped houses. According to legend, the ancestors of the Li people crossed the ocean long time ago and came to Hainan Island, and having nowhere to shelter, they flipped over their boats and made them into houses. In order to honor the memory of their ancestors, the later generations built their houses to resemble upside-down boats.
真的很像一艘船。
All houses have a thatched roof, which makes them resistant against strong wind and rain. There are no windows, but only doors on both ends of the house, which can help with air ventilation. Some of the houses are lifted up by cornerstones and have a space underneath. Those are granaries, and they're specially made this way to protect the grains from moisture and rats. But what's more interesting about the village is the fact that people moved out from here not so long ago.
People moved out from this village, from these houses, in 2008. Before that, it was just a regular village. It's hard to believe that less than 15 years ago, people used to live here, in these houses.
To sum it up, Baisha village is a great place to visit and get to know the local lifestyle and customs of the Li minority people. But we keep on going and exploring, and my next stop was Ledong County.
好的，我先去了乐东。 在路上看看有什么好玩的。
One of the things I definitely remembered about the southwest of Hainan is the roads. As I rode, they were getting better and better, newly built with a perfect surface, amazing scenery, and just a few cars.
I just wanted to stop here and, yeah, just to take a look for a second. Truly beautiful. Welcome to Ledong.
In Ledong, I tried the local Laoya old duck, which was tasty, but to my taste, Chonghai duck is better. Ledong is famous for its sunsets, so I headed in the direction of the coast. I couldn't reach the seashore, but still, the sunset was pretty beautiful. I stayed in the small town of Jiusuo. I was surprised by the amount of Dongbei people, people from the northeast of China. All the restaurants and hotels were run by people from Dongbei.
到这个地方，我就发现了这边到处都是东北人，我就是我来到东北一样。 Yeah, I got something to eat, or let me show you. 一份饺子、猪肉、大葱和肉饼，我很喜欢东北菜，我现在也要吃多一点。I need to prepare myself for tomorrow because tomorrow is going to be very difficult. 明天我要过三亚，但是我不能进去三亚，因为三亚城市进摩托车，所以我就要路过三亚，但是反正车会特别多。Let me have my dinner. I'm very tired as always, but it's totally alright because today has been a good day. I think I need like 3 or 4 more days and I'll be at my starting point. So hope you had a day. Good morning, everybody. It has some flavor. I don't like it too much. The guys from Tokyo, it's not the beans. It's that water. Let me get my breakfast. Some chow fan, some lian cai, some mantou. Millet porridge. Mmm, good. My face is getting worse and worse with every day. It doesn't look good. Time to go.
One of the shortcomings of traveling by motorcycle is that you always get very tired and you are always in discomfort. But at the same time, this is one of the best things because it is much more fun, and at the end of each day you feel like you have achieved a great result.
It's such a nice weather right now, it's just amazing. The sunshine with this, so beautiful with this long shadows, so nice, I love it.
I was going all along the coast, so the first thing I wanted to do was, of course, to see the South China Sea.
Amazing. Look at the water, it's so clean and pure. I've been riding the whole Hainan and this is the first time I see the water like this. I mean, like in the sea. Only here in the south. Beautiful. I love my motorcycle. Good job, buddy.
The place I wanted to visit that day was Sanya Nanshan Temple, which is like the pearl of Hainan Island. It is a must-see tourist attraction for people coming to Hainan. But for some reason, during all my time living here, I had never visited it. So this time, I decided to fix that.
Yes,
madam.
Okay.
129. It's a big shopping area here. You can go shopping if you want, but I don't need it. I need to go and see that huge Wanning monument. Let's go. 这是为什么我来到这里? This is huge.
Nanshan Cultural Tourism Zone is a large Buddhist complex with gardens, sculptures, sea views and different sites dedicated to Buddhist worship. The attraction that everybody comes here for is a massive three-sided Guanyin statue. It is 108 meters high and it is the tallest Guanyin statue in the world.
Throughout my trip, they were free. I have not paid entrance tickets. 今天是第一次我买了门票. It's totally worth it. Just incredible.
不是呢?
不是呢?
啊?
еще не попробовал?
啊,你知道。сейчас попробую.
黑线桥面说实话一半没有很多海鲜但是这个景区里面的吃的东西肯定是这样子没关系
Nanshan Tourism Zone is really huge. I get tired of walking back and forth, especially at noon, the hottest time of the day. For you to know, Sanya is the place with the strongest sunshine in Hainan. People call it a tropical paradise because even if it rains in other parts of Hainan, the sun is shining in Sanya.
凤凰机场就是在这儿，这是出发的哦。啊，我记得我接我的朋友们就是在这儿，我在这里下车，然后去接他们。现在我骑摩托车过，我的天哪！
I was going to Hohai, and because motorcycles are banned in Sanya, I had to go all the way around and take some really bad and narrow roads sometimes.
Where the hell am I going? 这是三亚吗?
Eventually, I had to make a really long detour where I could just take a straight road and save plenty of time and effort.
Linkin Park played my favorite band and one of my favorite songs, Nobody Can Save Me. It's a great day already.
我想在这儿，我要到后海，就是这个地方。这里有一条路，看到了没有？这里，大哥说我要这样走。 And the road is not good there. You see this like countryside road. They're fixing something here. I guess I'll just go this way because I'm just passing. I'm not going inside of the city. Maybe I'm breaking the rules and violating the rules, but come on, it's like it's much shorter, much easier. What do you think, guys? It makes sense, right?
So I think this water will be fine, hopefully.
In many cities in China, including Haikou and Sanya in Hainan, motorcycles are banned, and it hurts. I really wish there was a way for people who love motorcycles to do what we love, because it is just a part of us.
I think I made the right decision. On the road, I also saw a lot of motorcycles. No problem, no problem. Everything is fine. Go, go, go.
Kohai is a very popular village among young people and people interested in surfing. When I arrived there, I could feel the strong reggae vibe mixed together with local Hainan village style. It was pretty unique.
Too many people.
Too strong. I'm going to go with you. Come on. What are you doing? It's falling. Take it.
Kohai didn't meet my camping requirements, so I decided to go along the coast hoping to find a good camping spot. And it was not easy because eastern coast of Hainan is much more developed and there are hotels, resorts and people everywhere. Eventually I found a good spot, even though I think it was the hotel area, but there were no signs and no people approached me.
While I'm waiting till the day gets dark, I thought it might be a good idea to give you a look how I pack everything and how I carry all of the things on one motorcycle. This is my bag. I have a notebook that I've never used it in this trip. I don't know why I brought it. So in my bag, I keep all of my equipment. I keep my drone here, I keep my camera bag, I keep my lenses, keep my tripod right here, another tripod, some clips, sunglasses. Then I have my main case, box, how you call it. Here I keep my clothes, my tools, some GoPro camera bag with all the necessary things, my water kettle, cookies. So yeah, I keep most of the stuff here. It's very useful, I really like it. Here I have my sleeping bag. On the top I have special bag for my coffee. Keep it with this stretching net, so it's very useful. It got loosened like while I was on the way, so I had another rope. I just put it right here so it doesn't go anywhere. And here, because I have this kind of rack for the feet actually, but I use them to put things on it. Here I have my tent, here I have all the medicine, toothbrush. I keep it here. On this side I have my table and chair, my main tripod. All of them I tie with these elastic ropes. Actually this is only one elastic rope that goes from this side to this side. And it's very very useful, I really love it. I really love my setup. These are protection for my knees. I always wear them because anything could happen. You always have to keep in mind that you have to be safe. So yeah, this is basically it. It's simple. It's simple. But I think I should have bought a bigger case, a bigger box, because I think it's not enough. It's not enough. So that's it. Let's put a tent.
Sunrise was not as bright and clear as I had expected, but still, it was beautiful to see how the sun cuts through the clouds and pours its rays down on the vast sea below. I could see a drastic difference riding on the east coast after riding on the west. A better developed infrastructure, luxury hotels that bought out almost all the beach area, and there are just more people, more tourists, and it feels different.
This is a huge duty-free.
After getting disappointed that I still had to wait half an hour for the breakfast at KFC, I decided to go local style. And that was the right decision. I tried one of the best fentan I've ever had.
Yes. What?
Yo,
有份蛋有炒粉是吗？那我要一份那个粉蛋呗。
粉蛋啊？
对，加蛋。
加蛋啊？
对。哎呀，你们这里有没有什么茶呀？还是奶茶有吗？
奶茶，那种没有。你要喝，那里倒一杯给你喝。
如果可以的话，可以。
来，给我加一。
多谢谢你啊。
这是最好吃的粉蛋，我吃过的粉蛋，真的非常棒。I love 粉蛋 ，so good。
My first stop was Yetian Ancient Village in Lingshui County, a scenic spot where you can see and experience the local culture and customs of Hainan ethnic minorities.
对面吗？这里没有位置吗？
这里不能停。
这里不那么多车。
As you can see, I had a problem entering and parking my motorcycle, which was really weird. Inside of the village, you can get a deeper understanding of the customs and culture of the native Hainan people, the Li and Miao minorities. You can learn some of their language, find many traditional instruments, learn about the food and drinking culture, and also get to know their traditions. And the ticket is just 10 RMB.
Changjiang, 瓦里面有一条蛇。我的天哪！
大力，
纽大力，哦，纽大力，纽大力酒，我知道。
That day I didn't feel so good, both physically and mentally. I was tired and I was getting a bit discouraged, nothing could impress me, maybe because the trip was coming to an end. But that day I really didn't feel like filming. I stopped in some town close to Lingshui to copy my footage and headed to check out Clear Water Bay in Lingshui.
I don't know, I feel like I'm losing my motivation and my hand is getting tired vlogging. My lips hurt. I will just move along the coast right now and just will look for a place to camp. Yeah, like that.
Oh, I forgot one very important thing that you have to do when visiting Lingshui.
你们好，这里有酸粉是不是？好的，来一份。
在临水骑车，在路边都是酸粉，酸粉，酸粉。
到了临水一定要品尝这边的酸粉。
That afternoon, I explored almost every tiny bit of the coast, hoping to find a good camping site. I visited very beautiful beaches.
三十one.
Met some motorcycle friends.
Hello.
Going to?
I'm just riding around. These are yours?
Yeah, two.
Nice.
I also passed local towns with very busy and authentic markets, almost got stuck in the sand in the middle of nowhere, and saw watermelon plantations.
This is watermelon. Wow, nice.
And just before the sunset, I was lucky enough to find a great spot in some undeveloped area. As people say, where there is a will,There is a way.
Look, it's nice. It's like made for me. I'm staying here tonight. I'll put my tent just right here.
It's hard to describe my feelings that morning. I knew that it was the last camping night, the last cup of morning coffee, and the last sunrise during the trip. But no matter what, the new day was starting and new places were waiting to be seen and discovered. My first stop was the town of Sinlon, famous for its abundant overseas Chinese culture as well as its coffee. I was taking the road G223, which was full of great scenery, had little traffic, and was very comfortable to ride. In Sinlon, there is a famous restaurant with Southeast Asian cuisine, which I really wanted to visit, Sinlon Nanyang Fenwei. Everything was super tasty, the chicken curry was flavorful and tender, the desserts were excellent, and the coffee was delicious.
That was a good lunch.
Afterwards, I headed to Capital Outlets in Wanning. It's one of the biggest outlets in Hainan with an enormous number of different brands, a paradise for shopping. I'm not a big fan of shopping, but I needed to get new shoes.
I definitely need new shoes.
I think it's very easy to get lost here. Always too difficult to buy things, especially clothes. I'm happy that I've chosen one t-shirt. I didn't buy any shoes, but this is right. I will search in Taobao. I'm pretty happy with it. I've got a new t-shirt. That's awesome.
My next stop was the place I was very excited about. In Wanning, there is an extremely beautiful road, Wanning Luyou Gonglu. It stretches 74 kilometers in total, from Shimei Bay up to Dahuajiao, which I was going to visit next. But the most picturesque part is the one closest to the coast. It is incredibly beautiful. Well, you saw that. The entire road is extremely comfortable to ride. The green hills on one side, the azure sea on the other, the blue Hainan sky gives you a super contrasting tropical landscape. You always feel the sea breeze blowing on your face, which makes you smile and makes you think that life is not that bad and there are many things around us that can make us happy. We just need to go out there and see them. I arrived at Dahuajiao, a unique place in Hainan where you can find almost perfectly round rocks. The bay is located between two mountains and the waves washing up the shore are so strong that over the years they have turned the stones into different sized pebbles. And now this is the only place in Hainan with this natural phenomenon. Before heading to my starting point, I decided to stop by in the town called Hou'an and try the most authentic Hou'an fan. Strangely, it was not so easy to find because in the town there were almost no signs of Hou'an fan, just Lingshui Suan fan at every corner.
Hou'an fan.
有虾，我这个勺子可以了。
I'm not sure if it was authentic or not because it was the first time in my life that I've tried it, but it was definitely good.
So yeah, this is time I'm going back. This is my last stop for this trip. Kind of sad feeling that I'm going back. I will miss all of this, like exploring and visiting new places and camping and all of that. I will be missing it. But anyways, let's go to Changjiang.
Having crossed more than 1500 kilometers, having seen and explored different corners of Hainan, I was exhausted but satisfied. I was on the way back. It was hard to believe that I managed to fulfill my dream that I once had when I first came to this island, and that I could even document my journey and create a piece of art and memory that will live forever. The world is much more beautiful than we know. Sometimes we might not see it, but it is all out there. We just need to go and find it.
I still wander from time.